So good afternoon, students. So in the last class, I explained to you about the some problems based on the PROM, no? PROM. So that is made with a decoder as well as programmable R array. Okay. So we have seen that. So if you see the PLDs, so PROM consists of fixed AND array and programmable R array. And PAL consists of programmable AND array and fixed OR array, and PLA consists of both the programmable AND array and programmable OR array. Okay, so first we will see the PAL. Okay, so PAL is nothing but programmable array logic. Okay, so programmable array logic. Programmable. Array logic. So this is nothing but PAL. Okay, so PAL. Okay, so programmable array logic. So it consists of a set of AND gates and OR gates. Okay, a set of AND gates whose inputs are programmed. Okay, whose inputs are programmed and outputs are connected to OR gate. Okay, so that means AND gates are, those are programmed and OR gates are fixed. So let us take so this is the diagram for PAL. So you have the inputs A, B, and C, and here you are getting the complement of this one, A bar, B bar, and C bar. Okay, so here these AND gates are programmable. Okay, AND gates are programmable. So if it is programmable, you can make with a cross. Okay, a cross. Is an AND gate. Let us take all lines are programmed. This is one more AND gate. All lines are programmed. Okay, so the output that means you have fixed OR array. So that means that the output of the all the AND gates are given to OR gate. Okay, so this is the function. Okay, so you can note down about this. It consists of a set of AND gates whose input can be programmed, and whose outputs are connected to the OR gate, Okay. Initially, all the connection. Next point. Initially, all the connections are fused. Due to which output of each AND gate is zero. Hence the output of OR gate, hence the output is also zero. Okay. So here initially all the fuses are connected. So when all fuses are connected, the output of AND gates are zero. So if all the AND gates are zero, so this is given to the OR gates, you are getting the output is zero. Okay, initially all the connections are fused to with to which output of each AND gate is zero, okay, and hence output is also zero, okay. By removing the cross, we can include, next point, by removing the cross, we can include a literal. By removing the cross, we can include a literal. Literal means what? A variable, okay? A literal. In a logic expression. In a logic expression. And if all the fuses are blown, if all the fuses are blown, the output of AND gate are 1. If the all the fuses are blown, the output of AND gate are 1. In that case, output of OR gate is also 1. Okay. So that means when the all the fuses are blown, the output of the AND gate is 1. So that the output of the AND gates are given to the OR gate. So all are 1s means you are getting the output as 1. Okay. So now we'll see the programming table. So programming table. This programming table is nothing but so if one is mentioned under the input variable, then variable is included. So that means in the programming table, suppose one is mentioned, okay, so one is mentioned means that is included in the variable. Suppose zero is mentioned means, suppose if zero is mentioned in that, so what happens, input so it is nothing but complement of that, okay. If no one, nothing is included means we can call that as a dash, okay. So you can note down, if one is mentioned under input variable, if one is mentioned under input variable, then the variable is included. If one is mentioned in the input variable, then the variable is included. If zero is mentioned under input variable, if zero is mentioned under input variable, then its complement is included. If dash is included, dash is mentioned, neither the variable nor its complement is included. So if the dash is mentioned, neither the variable nor its complement is included. Okay, so let us take with example, like take this function f equal to ab bar plus b bar c. Okay, ab bar plus b bar c. Okay, now so we can draw the table. Okay, so here this is AND gate, and you have the literals or variables A, B, C. Okay, so for first, so first one, let us take this literal. Okay, this variable, this main term. So A, B. So how many variables are there? Three variables are there, A, B, C. Okay, this is a three variable. So it is a three variable. So how you can write? So A, B bar. So that means this is 1 and this is 0. So C is not there. That means you can represent with dash. Okay, so dash includes that the way, neither a variable nor its complement. Okay, so you can write here 1, 0 and dash, okay. And next 2, if you see, so 2 means B bar C. So B bar C means A is not included. This you can represent with dash. B bar means 0 and C means 1. So dash, 0 and 1, okay. So next third one, so nothing is included. So you can leave it like this. Okay, so from this table you can draw the PAL diagram. Okay, so we have the three variables. So one is A and its complement. Okay, A bar, and next B bar, C bar. Okay, so can extend this. Now one AND gate. So how we can program this AND gate? By using this table. So first AND gate, if you see, so A is 1, so that means this is fused. Okay, and here you have B bar, so that is 0, B bar is fused, and C bar is dash, that means it is not connected. Okay, so this is first AND gate, and the second AND gate. So you have, so if you see the table, so A is not there, that is not connected. B bar C, so B bar C means this is connected and C is connected. Okay, and the third gate, nothing is connected. Okay, so the output is given to an OR gate. Output is given to an OR gate. So you are getting the function, that means here you are getting 0, and here you are getting which function? A B bar. No, so A B bar, and here B bar C. Okay, so what is our function? A B bar plus B bar C plus 0. Okay, so that means from the Boolean algebra, A plus 0 is nothing but A itself. Okay, so you can write A B bar plus B bar C, so you'll get this function. Okay, so like this you can implement the given function by using the PAL, programmable array logic. Okay, so programmable array logic. Okay, so we'll take one more example. Okay, so let us take okay, this is about the PAL. Okay, next to PLA. So PL, what is PLA? Programmable logic array. Okay, so programmable logic array means what? So it consists of both and array is programmable, as well as OR array is programmable. Okay, so it consists of AND gates and as the inputs, and OR gates as a output. Okay, so that means both are programmed. Okay, so you can draw the diagram for this one. So this is, these are A, B, C inputs. Okay, so here you have AND array. Okay, so these are, let us take AND array. Total, let us take you have 5 ANDs. Okay, so these are connected. And here you have 4 ORs, 4 OR array. Okay. So all are fused. So that means these all are programmed. Okay, so program means AND array is programmed, Okay, so AND array is programmed. Okay. Parallelly, OR array is also programmed. OR array is also programmed. Okay, this is also programmed. Okay. So we'll take one example to implement this programmable logic array. So that is nothing but PLA. Okay. So that is nothing but this is PLA. So both AND array and OR array are programmable. Okay. So let us take this example T equal to AB bar plus AC plus BC bar. Okay. And C equal to AB bar plus BC plus AC. Okay. So now you need to draw the product table. So that means you have the product terms or min terms. Okay. And next you have the inputs. Inputs A, B, C. Okay. These are the inputs. And you have the outputs. Outputs. These are T and C. Okay. So first of all, write the product terms A, B bar, and next AC, BC bar. AB bar is already there, so no need to write again. So here BC, okay, and AC is also there. Okay, no need to write. Okay, so first of all, now what you need to do? This is one, and this is B is a complement, that is zero. And C is dash. Okay. And AC means you can write A is 1. So this is a dash. It is not there. Okay. And this is 1. And A is not there. So B you can write as 1. And C is 0. And here also dash B is 1. C is 1. Okay. Now you need to write the values for T and C. So if you see this one, so that means this AB bar is present in T. So that means you can write this T as 1. Okay. And next AC is also present in the T expression. So you can write this one as 1. Okay. BC bar is also present in this expression. You can write this as 1. Okay. And BC is not there, so you can write dash. Okay. And next AB, so if you write for C, so 1B bar. So 1B bar means AB bar is there. You can write in C expression. So that means you can write as 1. And next BC. So BC is also there. So BC means you can write as 1. BC AC is also there. Okay, AC is also there. You can write this as 1. But BC bar is not there. You can write dash. Okay. So this is nothing but we can call as a PLA table. So after drawing the PLA table, what you need to do? You need to draw the realization for the expression diagram for the PLA. Okay. So three variables are there. These are connected with a true form and complemented form inverter through the inverter. Okay, so these are A, B, C. So A bar, B bar, and C bar, complement of them. Okay, so next you have AND array. Okay, AND means how many product terms you have. So you have total, so if you see here, 4 product terms, okay, 4 AND gates will be there, okay, so 4 AND gates will be there. Okay, so these are given as outputs. And you have two functions, one is t and another one is c. Okay, so here this is nothing but t and this is nothing but c. Okay, now so what is this term? So for the first term is nothing but a b bar. Okay, a b bar. So a b bar means, so this one is a and this one is b bar. Okay, you are getting a b bar. And what is the next product term? AC. So this is A and this is C. Okay, you are getting AC. Okay, so next BC bar. Okay, so here this is B and this is C bar. Okay, you are getting BC bar. And next BC. So BC means so this is B and this is C. So you are getting BC. Okay, so again this is connected to all. So if you see t, so what is the expression for the t? So in the expression a b bar, a c, b c bar all are one and b c is not there. So that means you can fuse first three. So this AND array is programmable and as well as OR array is also programmable. And if you see the c expression, so c output, so first two terms are one and third term is not there and fourth term is there, one. Okay, so that means so first two terms are fused, this is not there, so that means no need to connect. So this is there, so this is connected. So like this you can implement the PLA, programmable logic array. Okay, so programmable logic array. Okay, so we'll solve some problems related to this PAL and PLA. Okay, so first one, you can note down, realize the following function using PAL with inputs. Realize the following function using a PLA with four inputs and three wide AND or structure three wide AND or structure also write a PAL program table. Okay, also write a PAL program table. Okay, so here you can write f1 of a b c d equal to summation of m of 6 8 9 12 to 15. Okay, and f2 of a b c d equal to summation of m of 1, 4, 2, 7, 10 to 30. Okay, and F3 of A, B, C, D equal to summation of M of 4 to 7, 10 to 11. Okay, and F4. So you need to use three wide AND or structure. Okay, so okay, so F4 of a b c d equal to summation of m of 4 to 7 and 9 to 15. Okay, so these are the values he given. So first of all, what you need to do, so in order to find out all these F1, F2, F3, F4, you need to apply the K-map for all the terms. Okay, these are four variable. So you need to, so for F1, K-map for F1. So K-map for F1. So this is A, B, C, D. Okay. So what is A, B, F1? So F1 is 6, 8. So so 6 8, okay, 6 8 9, okay, 12 to 15, 12 13 14 and 15. Okay, so here so this makes one quad. No, this makes one quad. Again, next, this makes one quad. Okay, this makes one pair. Okay, so what is F1? F1 you can write as, so this is so if you see this one, B, C, D bar, and this is A, B, and this is which one is common? A and C bar, 0 is common. So F1 you can write as A, B plus A, C bar plus B, C, D bar. Okay, and next so next F2, A, B, C, D. Okay, so what is that? One. Okay, so F2 of A, B, C, D is one. So one, and next 4 4 to 7. So 4 5 6 7. Okay, 4 5 6 7, and next 4 to 7, 10 to 13. Okay, so 8 9, again 10 11, 12 13. Okay, 10 to 13. Okay, this makes one quad. Okay, and also this makes one quad, this makes one pair. Okay, this also makes one pair. Okay, so you can write the min terms. So this is a bar B, and this is which one is common? A bar, 0 is common. A bar, C bar, D. Okay, and here this one is B, C bar, B, C bar, and here if you write, this is A, B bar, which is common? C, A, B bar, C. So what is F2? F2 equal to A bar B plus A B bar C plus A A bar C bar D plus B C bar. Okay, so here okay, so you got this expression. Now for F3, so AB and CD, 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, 0 0 0 1 1 0 1. Okay, so what is F3? 4 to 7. So 4 to 7 means here this is 4 5 6, 7. Okay, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 10 to 11. So this is 8, 9, 10, 11. 10 to 11. Okay. So this makes one quad and this makes one pair. Okay. So if you write for this one, you are getting A bar B plus A B bar C. So what is F3? F3 equal to A bar B plus A B bar C. Okay. A bar B plus A B bar C. Okay. So that means if you observe this F2, these terms are there. A bar B is there and A B bar C is also there. So that means F2, you can write as F3 plus A bar C bar D plus B C bar. Okay. So you can write like this. Okay. F2 equal to F3 plus A bar C bar D plus B C bar. Okay. Now F4. KMF for F4. So this is A, B, C, D. Okay. So what is F4? So F4 is nothing but 4 to 7 and 9 to 15. So you can draw, you can write the ones 4 to 7. So this is anyway 4, 5, 6, 7 and 9 to 13. So 9 to 13 means 8, this is 9 to 15. If you see the F4, 9 to 15. So 9 to 15 means 9, 10, 9, 10, 11, okay, 12, 13, 14, 15, okay. So that means this makes one octet, this makes one octet, and this makes one quad, this makes one quad, and also this makes one quad. Okay, so what is this one? Octet means you will get only one variable, that is nothing but B you are getting, and for this quad you are getting A, and which is common? AC you are getting, and for this one we are getting A, and next which one is common? One is common, D. Okay, so F4 you can write as B plus AD plus AC, B plus AD plus AC. Okay, so this is F4. Okay, so this is F3. Okay, this is F1. So here in terms of F3, you have F2. F3, you have F2. Now I should draw. Okay. So product terms, you need to draw the product terms. Okay. And terms and the output. Okay. Product terms and terms and output. Okay. So product terms. Product terms and input. And input. So you have the inputs A, B, C, D. Okay. So and F3. Why? Because F3 is getting as an input to the F2. Okay. So that's why F3 is also acting as a one input. Okay. Why? Because here I indicated F2 in terms of F3. F3 plus A bar C bar D plus B C bar. Okay. So that's why that is also one input, and outputs. Okay. So here you can draw the table. Okay. So if you see the product terms. So first product term, if you see the first product term, so what is the first product term? So if you see F1 equal to what? A, B. Okay. So A, B. So A, B means these two are one and remaining all are not there. Okay. And what is the next term in F1? A, C bar. So A, C bar. So next product term. So A, C bar. So this is one and this is not there. C bar means this is zero. Okay. That means dash. Okay. And the third term, if you see, third term B C bar B C D bar. Okay, B C D bar. Third one B. So this is B. Anyway, this is not there. B C. So this is one, and D bar. D bar is zero. Anyway, F3 is not there. Okay. So what is F1 over here? Output you are getting A B plus A C bar plus B C D bar. B C D bar. Okay. And next. So this is for what? F1. Okay. And for F2, fourth term if you see. So fourth term if you see. So first one is F3. Okay. So F3 means, so A is not there, B is not there, C is not there, D is not there. F3 is there. Okay. Now fifth one, you can say A bar, C bar, D. Okay. So A bar, C bar, D means A bar is zero, B is not there, C bar is zero, and D is there, and this is not there. Okay. And sixth term, what is sixth term? Sixth term, B C bar. Okay. B C bar means so this is not there. B means one, C bar means zero, B C bar, and these are not there. So what is F2? F2 you can write as A bar B plus A B bar C plus A bar C bar D plus B C bar. Okay. So this you can write as F3. So that is what is F2? F3 plus A bar C bar D plus B C bar. Okay. So you got F2. And next. Next for seventh one. Okay. So seventh one, F3 is nothing but A bar B. So A bar B means, so this is a zero and this is one, and remaining all are not there. Okay. And eighth one, A bar B plus A B bar C. A means this is one, B bar zero, and this is C. So this is one, and remaining all are not there. Okay. And ninth one, if you see, so that means this one is not there. Okay. So that means what is F3? F3 is nothing but A bar B. This is, that is not connected. So kept dash means no one of the literal is connected to the there. Okay. And next. So 10th one. So F4. So what is F4? B plus AD plus AC. So B. So here B is one, and remaining all are dash. Okay. And AD means, so A is one, and this is a dash, C is dash, D is one, and this one. Okay, you are getting. And 12th one, AC. So AC means this is one, and this one is dash, this one is one, and this one is dash. Okay. So what is F4? F4 equal to B plus AD plus AC. Okay. So you got the table. So you got the table. So you drawn the table. So what is the next thing? So next you need to realize by using the which one? PAL. Okay. So programmable array logic. So in programmable array logic, which one is fixed and which one is programmable? So which one is fixed and which one is programmable? Or you can realize with PLA also. Okay. So you have programmable AND array. So in PAL you have programmable AND array and fixed OR array. Okay. So fixed OR array. So here I'm drawing the inputs. So this is A. And this is B. C. C bar. D. D bar. Okay. So these are the inputs. Okay. Now you need to draw the AND gates. So what is the first AND gate? So if you see the table, so which is connected? A and B are connected. Okay. So A and B are connected. Okay. So if you see, by seeing the table, you can draw A and B are fused. Okay. And next, so next, A C bar, A C bar. So this is A, and this is B, and this is C bar. Okay. So what is the next term? BC. BC. Okay. And next. So you need to include F3 also. F3 has one input. Okay. So here I can make F3 as one input. So this is nothing but F3. So if you see this this one, F2 equal to what? So first is F3. You are getting F3. Okay. So this is F3. This is F3. And second term. So here you are getting A bar C bar D. Okay. A bar C bar D. So this one is A bar, and here this is C bar. Sorry, this is A bar. Okay, this is F3. No? A bar. So this is B, and this is C. C bar. Okay, D. A bar C bar D. Okay, so this is A, B, C, and this one is D. Okay. And next, A bar, C bar, D, B, C bar. So this is B, and this one is C bar, B, C bar. Okay. So next, A bar B plus A B bar C. Okay. A bar B. Okay. So A bar B. So A bar B plus A B bar C. So here you can write A bar. So this is A bar B, A B bar C. Okay, A B bar C. So here A, and next B bar. So this is C. So anyway, this is not connected. Okay, this is not connected. And next, so here this one is A, and this one is B. And this one is C, and this one is D. Okay, this is F3. You need to remember. So next, if you see the last term, B. B plus AD plus AC. Okay. So first, this one is B. Okay. And next, AD. So this is A, and this is D. AC. So this is A, and this is C. Okay. So next, so you can draw. So you can draw from here. There are how many outputs? You have four outputs. F1, F2, F3, no? F1, F2, F3, and F4. Okay. So this is F1. is coming with an OR gate. Okay. F2. F3. And F4. Okay. So here what is, so this is F1, F2, F3 and F4. Okay. So what is F1? F1 is these three. Okay. So these are fixed. I can make this contact. Okay. These are not programmed, just contact. Okay. Again, F2. So F2 means a combination of this. Okay, and F3, if you see the combination of this one, and F4, the combination of this one. Okay. So here this F3 is there, no? So F3 is connected to where? You should get the F3, no? So what is F3 actually? What is F3? F3 equal to what you got? So F3 equal to you got A bar B plus A bar B plus A B bar C. Okay. So this is nothing but actually F3. Okay. So this is acting as a one input to which one? F2. Okay. So that you need to give as input, no? So that means the output of F3 is giving as the input to F2. So that means here you need to give the output. The output of F3 is connected as an input to the F2. Okay. So like this, the realization will be there. Okay. So this is about the realization of PAL. In the next class, we'll see about PL. Okay. Some problems related to PL.